All right, we're going to kick things off here in Visual Studio Code. The first thing that we need to ensure is that we have access to the models that are going to be best if you ever need to invoke the AI Toolkit tools with Copilot. To check that, at the very top, you're going to select the toggle chat icon, and that'll open up Copilot. And then towards the bottom of Copilot, where you can pick a model, you'll select that dropdown. You'll want to have access to either GPT-5 Mini, Claude Haiku 4.5, Claude Opus 4.5, Claude Sonnet 4, or Claude Sonnet 4.5. The next thing that we need to do is create a project in Microsoft Foundry. And we're going to do that in the new Foundry experience. To access the new Foundry experience, at the very top of the screen, there is a toggle that says New Foundry. You'll select that toggle. And in doing that, you're going to have the option to select a project to continue. If you already have a Foundry project, then great, you can select that project from the dropdown. But if you do not, then the first thing that you'll need to do is select the dropdown, followed by create a new project. From here, you can give your project a name. So I'm just going to call mine GHCP demo. And then from there, in the advanced options section, you'll need to select the appropriate subscription. So if you have access to more than one subscription in Foundry, you'll select the dropdown and choose the proper one. You'll also need to choose a resource group. So by default, a new one will be created. However, you can select an existing resource group from the dropdown. If you need to change the name of the one that we are going to create by default for you, you'll select create new resource group and you'll have the flexibility to change the name there. The next thing that you'll need to do is also create a Microsoft Foundry resource. So you can change the name that we have here for you. What we've done is populate based on the project name and we've appended resource at the very end. And then the final thing you'll need to do is select a region. So the region is going to be based on where you are located or more so where whatever it is you're creating will be deployed to. This can also be impacted on how much quota you have available for whatever given model that you plan to use. I'm going to keep things at East US2 here, and then I'll click Create. Once you click Create, Foundry is going to set up the project for you. This will take a couple of minutes, but once the project has been created, it'll land you right on the welcome screen. And here we are. This is the welcome screen. So back here in Visual Studio Code, the next thing that we need to do is ensure that we have the proper extensions installed. To do so, we're going to open up extensions. The first one is going to be Azure Resources, and I have that here on my screen. You're going to install this extension. This extension is going to enable us to get access to our Foundry project that was just created. The second one that we'll also want to have is the AI Toolkit for Visual Studio Code. This is an extension pack, so when you install this one, you're also going to get the Microsoft Foundry extension as well. So the next thing that we need to do is sign in to the Azure Resources extension so that we can get access to the Foundry project that we've created. To do so, you're going to open up the Azure Resources extension, and it's a Azure icon. And then the first thing at the top that you'll see is sign in to Azure. You'll select that. You'll then be notified that the extension wants to sign in using Microsoft. You'll select Allow. And then from here, you'll go through a series of prompts to log in. So I'm going to sign in with my account. And then if it's necessary to authenticate, you'll do that as well using the Authenticator app. And then from there, you're going to be asked whether you want to sign in to all apps, websites, and services on this device. Select whichever one is going to be most appropriate for your current use. I'm going to go ahead and select Know This App Only. And then from there, you're just going to wait for Azure to sign in. Once Azure has been signed in, under the resources section, you're going to see the different subscriptions or tenants that you have access to. And I happen to have three. To set our default project, what you're going to do is open up the subscription that you created your Foundry project in. So again, I have access to more than one. So I selected the one where I knew that I created the project. And then you're going to scroll down to where it says Microsoft Foundry. You're going to expand that. And then from here, you're going to find the project that you created. So if you recall, mine is GHCP demo. and you're going to right click on that. You're going to open it in the Microsoft Foundry extension. So that'll open up the Foundry extension. And what that's going to do is set the default project. Now, in the event you actually have multiple projects and you chose the wrong one, while you're in the Microsoft Foundry extension, you can right click on the project that's set as a default, and then you'll select Switch Default Project in Azure Extension, and then it'll give you a list of projects available. So you'll go through selecting your subscription, and then from there, you'll choose the proper project. And those are the steps for setting up your VS Code environment for using GitHub Copilot with the AI Toolkit tools and Microsoft Foundry.